Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture series on the subject Engineering Thermodynamics. This is Module 3. The topic is Second Law of Thermodynamics. So, we are discussing on the Second Law of Thermodynamics. This is lecture number 307. We recap from the previous lectures. So, in the previous lectures, we discussed the Carnot cycle, heat engine cycle and the efficiency of the heat engine cycle, refrigerator, heat pump and COP of refrigerator and heat pump. And we solved problems on the refrigerator, heat pump and heat engine cycle. And we continue with the problem. The topic for this lecture is also problems on the second law of thermodynamics. And the learning outcome is, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problems on second law of thermodynamics. So, all the problems whatever we solve in the lectures, they are taken only from the Anna University question paper. So, this is again from November 2017 question paper, example number 18. A Carnot engine getting heat at 800 Kelvin is used to drive a Carnot refrigerator maintaining 280 Kelvin temperature. Both the engine and the refrigerator reject heat to the same temperature T. When the heat given to the engine equal to the absorbed by the refrigerator, determine the efficiency and COP of the refrigerator. And this is the diagram that indicates the problem. A Carnot engine getting 800 Kelvin, heat at 800 Kelvin. So, the source temperature is 800 Kelvin. The engine is giving heat energy, getting heat energy from the source. And it is driving a Carnot refrigerator which is maintaining temperature 280 Kelvin. So, this is what the temperature of the refrigerator space 280 Kelvin. Both the engine and the refrigerator reject heat to the same temperature. So, the two temperatures are equal, T1 equal to T4. And when the heat given to the engine equal to the heat absorbed by the refrigerator. So, heat given to the engine is Q1. Heat absorbed by the refrigerator is Q3. When these two are equal, determine efficiency and COP of the refrigerator. The efficiency of the heat engine. So, eta is defined in terms of temperature, T1 minus T2 divided by T1, which is also equal to W divided by Q1. And from the definition of the efficiency, we calculate W. So, W work done equal to work output from the heat engine equal to T1 minus T2 divided by T1 into Q1. So, this is the work output of the heat engine. And the COP of the refrigerator, so the T3 divided by T4 minus T3. So, the temperature, this is what the refrigerator space, the temperature of the refrigerator space divided by the work done. So, T3 by T4 minus T3. And from the condition of the problem, T2 equal to T4. So, T4 equal to T2. So, T3 by T2 minus T3 equal to Q3 divided by W, COP equal to Q3 divided by W, desired effect divided by the work input. And this COP equal to Q3 by W, so substituting for W from the previous derivation, W equal to T1 minus T2 divided by T1 into Q1 and rearranging Q3 by Q1 into T1 by T1 minus T2. And again look at the problem, the condition is Q1 equal to Q3, so when Q1 equal to Q3, this is getting cancelled. The COP in terms of temperature T3 by T2 minus T3. So, T3 by T2 minus T3 equal to T1 by T1 minus T2. Substituting the temperature T3 equal to 280 Kelvin minus divided by T2 minus 280 equal to T1 is 800 Kelvin divided by 800 minus T2. And here T2 is the unknown. So, solving this equation, you will get T2 equal to 414.8 Kelvin. Now, the efficiency of the heat engine, eta equal to T1 minus T2 divided by T1. Which is equal to 800 minus 414.8 divided by 800 equal to 0.48, which is 48%. And the COP of the refrigerator, COP equal to T3 by T4 minus T3, which is COP equal to 280 divided by 414.8 minus 280 equal to 2.07. And the answer to the problem, efficiency of the heat engine is 48%, COP of the refrigerator equal to 2.07. We take example number 9, from the Anna University question paper, May 2015 and May 2017, a reversible heat engine operates between two reservoirs at temperature 600 degrees Celsius and 40 degrees Celsius. So the heat engine is operating between 600 degrees Celsius, which is 873 Kelvin, 40 degrees Celsius, which is 313 Kelvin. The engine drives a reversible refrigerator which operates between the reservoir at 40 degrees Celsius and minus 20 degrees Celsius. So the heat engine is operating the refrigerator, which is operating between minus 20 degrees Celsius, which is 253 Kelvin, and 40 degrees Celsius, which is 313 Kelvin. The heat transfer to the heat engine is 2000 kilojoules. So the amount of heat given to the heat engine Q1 equal to 2000 kilojoules. Net work output from the combined engine refrigerator is 360 kilojoules. So the heat produced, work produced by the heat engine is given to the refrigerator. The excess amount of work produced is 360 kilojoules. Calculate the heat transfer to the refrigerant and net heat transfer to the reservoir at 40 degree Celsius. So efficiency of the heat engine, we define the efficiency of the heat engine. So eta equal to 1 minus T2 by T1, which is equal to 1 minus 313 divided by 873 equal to 0.642, which is 64.2%. And this eta is also equal to W by Q1. So W, work output of the heat engine, equal to eta into Q1, which is 0.642 into 2000, which is 1284 kilojoules. And this W equal to Q1 minus Q2. So Q1 minus Q2 equal to W. So Q2 equal to heat rejected is equal to Q1 minus W equal to 2000 minus 1284 equal to 716 kilojoules. The amount of heat given rejected by the heat engine equal to 716 kilojoules. Work given to the refrigerator. So the work produced by the heat engine is 1284. Minus 360 equal to 924 kilojoules. So work given to the refrigerator is 924 kilojoules, and this COP of the refrigerator T3 by T4 minus T3 equal to 253 divided by 313 minus 253 equal to 4.22, and the COP is also defined as Q3 by W. So the desired effect divided by the work input to the refrigerator. So Q3 equal to COP into W, which is equal to 4.22 into 924 equal to 3899.28 kilojoules. Now Q4, heat rejected from the refrigerator, Q4 equal to Q3 plus W, which is equal to 3899.28 plus 924 equal to 4823.28 kilojoules. So the amount of heat given to the sink at T4 equal to 4823.28 kilojoules. Now net heat transfer to the reservoir at 40 degrees Celsius by the heat engine and the refrigerator. So Q2 plus Q4 equal to 716 plus 4823.28, which is equal to 5539.28 kilojoules. So the answer to the problem, the heat transfer to the refrigerant Q3 equal to 3899.28 kilojoules, and the net heat transfer to the reservoir at 40 degrees Celsius equal to 5539.28 kilojoules. So next we take the example number 10 from the Anna University question paper, November 2013. A reversible heat engine operates between the two reservoirs at a temperature 600 degrees Celsius and 40 degrees Celsius. So heat engine is operating between 600 degrees Celsius and 40 degrees Celsius. The engine drives the reversible refrigerator which operates between the reservoir at a temperature 40 degrees Celsius and minus 20 degrees Celsius. So the refrigerator is operating between minus 20 degrees Celsius, which is 253 Kelvin, and 40 degrees Celsius, which is 313 Kelvin. The heat transfer to the heat engine is 2000 kilojoules. So Q1 equal to 2000 kilojoules. The net and the net work output of the combined engine refrigerator is 360 kilojoules. So the heat engine is giving work to the refrigerator. The balance or excess amount of work produced by the heat engine equal to 360 kilojoules. So calculate the heat transfer to the refrigerant and net heat transfer to the reservoir at 40 degrees Celsius. Number 2, reconsider the first problem. So we have to recalculate everything given that the efficiency of the heat engine and COP of the refrigerator are each 40% of the maximum possible value. So the entire problem is depicted in a diagram. So it is heat engine and refrigerator combined, and work produced equal to net work done equal to 360 kilojoules. So Q1 equal to 2000 kilojoules. So we have to calculate Q3, Q2 and Q4. First, efficiency of the heat engine, eta equal to 1 minus Q2 by T1 equal to 1 minus 313 divided by 873 equal to 0.642, which is 64.2%. The eta is also given by W by Q1. So work done by the heat engine, W equal to eta into Q1 equal to 0.642 into 2000, which is equal to 1284 kilojoules. The amount of heat rejected by the heat engine, Q2 equal to Q1 minus W, which is 2000 minus 1284 equal to 716 kilojoules. The work given to the refrigerator, W equal to 1284 minus 360 equal to 924 kilojoules, and COP of the refrigerator, so the COP equal to T3 by T4 minus T3, which is equal to 253 divided by 313 minus 253 equal to 4.22, and the amount of heat rejected by the refrigerator, Q3 equal to COP into W, which is 4.2 to 924 equal to 3899.28 kilojoules, and the amount of heat given to the source, heat given to the sink by the refrigerator, or heat rejected to the atmosphere equal to Q3 plus W, which is 3899.28 plus 924 equal to 4823.28 kilojoules. The net heat transfer to the reservoir at 5 degrees Celsius, it is equal to Q2 plus Q4 equal to 716 plus 4823.28 equal to 5539.28 kilojoules. So this is the first part of the problem. So in the first part, we have calculated Q2 and calculated Q3 and Q2 plus Q4. So Q4 also we have calculated. Q2, Q3, Q4, everything we have calculated. Now when the efficiency of the heat engine and COP of the refrigerator are each 40% of the maximum possible value. So we have to recalculate everything with actual efficiency of the heat engine equal to 40% of 0.642 equal to 0.2568. Now the actual work done by the heat engine, so W equal to eta into Q1, which is 0.2568 into 2000 equal to 513.6 kilojoules. And the heat rejected by the heat engine, Q2 equal to Q1 minus W equal to 2000 minus 513.6 equal to 1486.4 kilojoules. Now, work given to the refrigerator, 513.6 minus 360 equal to 153.6 kilojoules, and the actual COP of the refrigerator equal to 0.4 into 4.22, which is 1.688. Then the heat extracted by the refrigerator, Q3 equal to COP into W, so 1.688 into 153.6 equal to 259.3, and the heat rejected by the refrigerator, Q4 equal to Q3 plus W, so 259.6 plus 153.6 equal to 412.9 kilojoules, and the net heat transfer to the reservoir at 40 degrees Celsius, so Q2 plus Q4 equal to 1486.4 plus 412.9 equal to 1899.3 kilojoules. So everything we calculate. So the everything, all the parameters. So we take the base parameter from the previous part of the problem, and we calculate with 40% efficiency and 40% of the COP. So that is what we are doing here. And the answer to the problem, number one, for ideal condition, the heat transfer to the refrigerant equal to 3899.28 kilojoules, and net heat transfer to the reservoir at 40 degrees Celsius equal to 5539.28 kilojoules. When the efficiency of the heat engine and COP of the refrigerator are each 40% of their maximum possible value, then heat transfer to the refrigerant Q3 equal to 259.3, and the net heat transfer to the reservoir at 40 degrees Celsius equal to 1899.3 kilojoules. So there is the answer to the problem. And example number 11. So from the unanswered question paper, November 2019. The Carnot heat engine works between two temperature, 900 Kelvin and 300 Kelvin. So the heat engine is working between 900 Kelvin and 300 Kelvin. It operates a Carnot refrigerator between two temperature, 300 Kelvin and 250 Kelvin. So the heat engine is operating a refrigerator which is working between 250 Kelvin and 300 Kelvin. The heat engine is supplied with 50 kilojoules per second of heat energy. So heat supplied to the heat engine is 50 kilojoules per second. And it is not only operates a refrigerator, but also delivers a net power of 10 kilowatt. So the work produced by the heat engine is given to the refrigerator. There is excess amount of work produced that is equal to 10 kilowatt. Determine the heat transfer to the refrigerant in the refrigerator and net heat transfer to the sink at 300 Kelvin. So again, in the problem, we have to calculate Q3, Q2 and Q4. And the part 2 of the problem, we recalculate everything with the actual efficiency of the heat engine and actual COP of the refrigerator are 50% of the maximum value. A similar type of problem with the different data. Now, so the entire problem is given here in the form of a diagram. So efficiency of the heat engine, first we take the heat engine. Efficiency of the heat engine eta equal to 1 minus T2 by T1, which is 1 minus 300 by 900 equal to 0.67, so 67%. And the work produced by the heat engine cycle, so eta is also equal to W by Q1, so work done by the heat engine, so eta into Q1 equal to 0.67 into 50, which is 33.5 kilojoules. And the heat rejected by the heat engine, so Q2 equal to Q1 minus W equal to 50 minus 33.5 equal to 16.5 kilojoules. So this is the, so we calculated W equal to 33.5 kilojoules and Q2 equal to 16.5 kilojoules. Now work given to the refrigerator, W equal to 33.5 minus 10 equal to 23.5 kilojoules. Now for the COP of the refrigerator, COP equal to T3 by T4 minus T3 equal to 250 divided by 300 minus 250 equal to 5. And COP is also given by Q3 by W. The Q3 amount of heat extracted by the refrigerator, Q3 equal to COP into W, which is 5 into 23.5 equal to 117.5. And the heat rejected by the refrigerator, Q4 equal to Q3 plus W, which is equal to 117.5 plus 23.5 equal to 141 kilojoules. Now the net heat transfer to the reservoir at 300 Kelvin equal to Q2 plus Q4, which is equal to 16.5 plus 141 equal to 157.5 kilojoules. So this is the first part of the problem. So here we have calculated Q2, the amount of heat rejected by the heat engine, Q3, the amount of heat extracted by the refrigerator, and the Q4, the amount of heat rejected by the refrigerator. So the total heat rejection to the reservoir at 300 Kelvin is also we have calculated. Now we reconsider the entire problem with 50% efficiency. So when the efficiency of the heat engine and COP of the refrigerator are each 50% of their maximum possible value. Now the actual efficiency of the engine is 0.5 into 0.67 equal to 0.3335, and the actual work done by the heat engine eta into Q1 equal to 0.3335 into 50 equal to 16.675 kilojoules. Heat rejected by the heat engine Q2 equal to Q1 minus W equal to 50 minus 16.675 equal to 33.325 kilojoules. And work given to the refrigerator is 16.675 minus 10 equal to 6.675 kilojoules, and the actual COP of the refrigerator, COP equal to 0.5 into 5 equal to 2.5, and the heat extracted by the refrigerator, Q3 equal to COP into W, so 2.5 into 6.675 equal to 16.68 kilojoules, and the heat rejected by the refrigerator, Q4 equal to Q3 plus W, which is 16.68 plus 6.675 equal to 23.355 kilojoules. And the net heat transfer to the reservoir at 300 Kelvin, which is equal to Q2 plus Q4 equal to 33.325 plus 23.355 equal to 56.68 kilojoules. Now, answer to the problem, for ideal conditions, the heat transfer to the refrigerant Q3 equal to 117.5 kilojoules, and the net heat transfer to the reservoir at 300 Kelvin equal to 157.5 kilojoules. When the efficiency of the heat engine and the COP of the refrigerator are 50% of the maximum possible value, then the heat transfer to the refrigerant Q3 equal to 16.68 kilojoules, and the net heat transfer to the reservoir at 300 Kelvin equal to 56.68 kilojoules. And example number 12, a heat pump is working on Carnot cycle, takes in heat from a reservoir at 5 degrees Celsius and delivers heat to a reservoir at 60 degrees Celsius. The heat pump is driven by a reversible heat engine which takes in heat from your reservoir at 840 degrees Celsius and reject heat to your reservoir at 60 degrees Celsius. The reversible heat engine also drives a machine which absorbs 30 kilowatts. If the heat pump extracts 17 kilojoules from 5 degrees reservoir, determine the rate of heat supply from the 840 degrees source and the rate of heat rejection to the 60 degrees sink. So, this is from May 2017 question paper. So, this is the heat pump operating between 5 degrees Celsius and 60 degrees Celsius and it extracts heat energy Q3 equal to 17 kilojoules per second and the heat engine is operating between 840 degrees Celsius and 60 degrees Celsius. The work produced by the heat engine is given to the heat pump and the excess heat is also used to drive another machine of 30 kilowatts. So, given data T1 equal to 840 degrees Celsius which is 1113 Kelvin, T3 equal to 5 degrees Celsius which is 278 Kelvin, T4 equal to 60 degrees Celsius which is 333 Kelvin. So, for the heat pump COP equal to T4 minus T3, COP equal to 333 divided by 333 minus 278 equal to 6.05 and COP equal to Q4 minus Q3, the Q4 is unknown here. So, 6.05 equal to Q4 by Q4 minus 17. So, the 6.05 into Q4 minus 6.05 into 17 equal to Q4. So, rearranging and calculating Q4 equal to 20.36 kilojoules. The amount of heat extracted given rejected by the heat pump equal to 20.36 kilowatts. COP of the heat pump is Q4 divided by W. So, the W equal to Q4 by COP, so 20.36 divided by 6.05 equal to 3.36 kilowatts. So, the work given to the heat pump equal to 3.36 kilowatts. So, for the heat engine, the work produced by the heat engine equal to 30 plus 3.36 kilowatts, which is 33.36 kilowatts. Now, the efficiency of the heat engine is eta equal to 1 minus T2 by T1, which is 1 minus 333 divided by 1113 equal to 0.7. And the eta is also equal to W by Q1. So, the heat absorbed by the heat engine W by eta equal to 33.36 divided by 0.7 equal to 47.65 kilowatts. So, from the definition of E2 once again, eta equal to 1 minus Q2 by Q1. So, 0.7 equal to 1 minus Q2 by 46.75. So, Q2 equal to 0.3 into 47.65 equal to 14.295 kilojoules. So, the heat rejected by the heat engine equal to 14.295 kilojoules. So, the rate of heat supply from 840 degrees Celsius source Q1 equal to 47.65 kilojoules and the rate of heat rejection to 60 degrees Celsius sink equal to Q4 plus Q2 equal to 20.36 plus 14.295 equal to 34.655 kilojoules per second and the answer to the problem. The rate of heat supply from a 840 degrees Celsius source equal to 47.65 kilojoules and rate of heat rejection to the 60 degrees Celsius sink equal to 34.655 kilojoules per second. So, we stop here. So, these are all the reference book I used for preparing the slides. You can also refer to it for additional information and you can write to my mail ID for any queries or doubts. I will answer to your queries. So, thank you for watching and we will meet again.